talking about Johnny, I mean, obviously he's such a huge superstar, but particularly, I mean, I think that character has become, I think, what he's best loved and best known for. What do you think it was about his particular approach to Jack Sparrow that gave it that kind of instant iconic and kind of cult status?
Well, I mean, I think that you couldn't put your finger on it. That you couldn't quite really, you didn't know what exactly what he was doing. Like that the character had something going on in his mind that no one else could quite get a hold of. And in a way, like in the famous, in the theater history, like the Harlequin character, the Harlequino, the trickster, he really exemplified that kind of character who even in the most kind of dangerous situation could figure a way out, you know, using a combination of kind of swashbuckle and kind of craziness, you know. And I also think that Johnny, with that character, found a way to kind of do what he was known, his trademark quirkiness and his originality that he put into characters. But he just breathed such a life into that role that our thought of pirates is forever changed. Because what he represented as Jack Sparrow was a non-conformist in an ever-conforming world. And that's what a lot of us identify with. And that's why that Jack Sparrow character's done so great for charity all over the world. People doing, playing that character and embodying kind of that sense of freedom that that Johnny brought out of it. But really it's that, if you think about it, it was, he was like, he says he likes to base it on who were the rock stars of the day, and that's why he picked, that the pirates were the rock stars of that era, and that's why he chose Keith as his image and then, right, kind of copied him even in his trademark look and stuff. But Johnny's just a step ahead of everyone. And I think that's really what makes him so fantastic, is that he's a true artist. You know, and that he achieved the heights of the movie business on that is such a credit to his talent, you know, and his tenacity. He absolutely was just normal Johnny, you know, and occasionally he would jump into it, but for the most part, everyone on that movie had a fairly technical approach to the character. We'd be in the middle of some rollicking story almost every time they were just about to roll, and then everyone gets the character, cut, back to the end of the story. And I think that was led a lot by Johnny and Jeffrey Rush and stuff, and their professionalism, you know. And there's definitely there's a time to concentrate. It's probably that you do your homework before you come to set. You're ready to play, and then he doesn't take it out on everyone. Johnny's a very powerful guy, and you know, there's a rule in the film business that whoever that number one star is on the call sheet, the rest of us actors get to act or not act based on how that person's behavior is. So if that number one star is a class person, everyone's got to kind of toe the line of being a class act. And that's Johnny's story.